Hello everyone and welcome back to the Perfect French with Dylan. Today we are going to learn everything about the participe présent and the gérondif. And on the book we are going to go from page 277 to 281. Le participe présent is used in both English and French, but we have very different rules around it. In French, it's a very formal way to speak. So, mostly for newspaper, formal speaking, news, books, etc. We have two different ones. We have the participe présent and we have the gérondif. The gérondif is simply the participe présent with the little en in front, en. But first, let's focus on the participe présent. So, how many times did I tell you that you need to know by heart all the verbs conjugated in the present tense, because we use it to build other tenses. Well, the participe présent is another one of those tenses. We are going to take the conjugation in the present tense with nous, remove the ending ons, and simply add ant. In English, the equivalent is word ending in ing, but not always. It's not as simple as that. So let's see a few. If we look at donner in the present tense, we have nous donnons. If we remove the ons, we have d-o-n-n, and then we add a-n-t, and we have donnant. Donnant is the participe présent. We don't have a pronoun in front, we don't have je, we don't have tu, etc. This is not this kind of conjugation. Finir, we have nous finissons, finissant. Attendre, nous attendons, attendant. Nous prononçons, prononçant. Nous mangeons, mangeant. Craindre, we have nous craignons, craignant. You have a few more in the book. We have only three irregular, of course. We have avoir, être, and savoir. Avoir is ayant. Être is étant. And savoir is sachant. If you want to try to build the participe présent, you can try to do the exercise 15.1. So when do we use the participe présent? We actually use more the gérondif. So we have only mostly one use for the participe présent. It's when it refers to a noun, and in this case, we use it the exact same way as in English. Let's see a few examples we have. Voyant Karen, il a changé de direction. Voyant Karen, il a changé de direction. So here, the participe présent is voyant. So it refers to Karen. Another one. Habitant près de la gare, il est constamment dérangé par le bruit des trains. Habitant près de la gare, il est constamment dérangé par le bruit des trains. Living by the train station, he is constantly bothered by the noise of train. So, habitant is the participe présent. So, you see here, we use it the exact same way as in English. Don't overthink it too much, I will say. You're most likely not going to use it when you speak. You're going to find it in books. If one day you ever write a book in French, you're obviously going to use it. But you're most likely not going to use it. But you might actually use the gérondif more. I told you that the gérondif is made out of the participe présent with en before, en. We are going to use it to talk about an action related to the verb. Usually when we want to talk about two things happening at the same time. And it's going to be translated in English by while or upon. This one is very easy. Let's see. J'écoute toujours de la musique en travaillant. J'écoute toujours de la musique en travaillant. I always listen to music while working. So here we have two different things. We have listening to music and working, and happening at the same time. So while working, en travaillant. Another one. Nous avons rencontré Paul en mangeant au restaurant. Nous avons rencontré Paul en mangeant au restaurant. We met Paul while eating at the restaurant. We eat at the restaurant and we meet Paul. Two actions happening at the same time. En mangeant. Another way that we use the gérondif is to talk about the cause of the action. Or the cause of the situation. And it translates in English to buy. B-Y. Elle a gagné 3 millions en jouant à la loterie. Elle a gagné 3 millions en jouant à la loterie. She won 3 million by playing the lottery. Seeing how many times I use this sentence in the book, you can guess that I really wanna win the lottery. En jouant à la loterie by playing the lottery is the cause of the situation. She won because she played. Another one. Il s'est fait mal en tombant de la chaise. Il s'est fait mal en tombant de la chaise. It hurt himself by falling from the chair. So the cause is by falling from the chair. En tombant is the gérondif. The third one, and maybe the most confusing one, but also the one that you're going to encounter the less. So let's just see over it for information, but honestly, I don't think you will really see it often. We are going to use the gérondif without en to replace a relative clause. Usually, this clause includes the word qui. Let's see two examples. We have. Nous cherchons des guides qui parlent français. Nous cherchons des guides qui parlent français. So, qui parle français, we are going to replace qui parle by a gérondif without en. Qui parle français? Nous cherchons des guides parlant français. Nous cherchons des guides parlant français. So, we are looking for guides who speak French. Another one. Les passagers qui attendent le train de 16h sont priés de changer de quai. Les passagers qui attendent le train de 16h sont priés de changer de quai. So if we replace qui attendent, we have les passagers attendant le train de 16h sont priés de changer de quai. Les passagers attendant le train de 16h sont priés de changer de quai. I feel like I'm the person talking at the train station. So you see this one, you are not going to use it too much, but it's very good to know. Now let's see an example with a participe present and with a gérondif to see the difference. And we are going to take the one that we are going to use the most, which is to talk about simultaneity. So to talk about things happening at the same time. So if we say, j'ai vu Nicole traversant la rue. J'ai vu Nicole traversant la rue. I saw Nicole crossing the street. Here, traversant acts as a participe présent. It describes what Nicole was doing. And she was crossing the street. But if we change the participe présent into a gérondif, we have j'ai vu Nicole en traversant la rue. J'ai vu Nicole en traversant la rue. I saw Nicole while crossing the street. Here, en traversant is a gérondif. It describes what I was doing when I saw Nicole. If there's one thing that you have to remember from this lesson, will be en traversant. So the gérondif that we use to talk about two things happening at the same time. That's the one that you're going to use the most. If you want to practice, you can do the exercises 15.2 and 15.3. Tomorrow, we are going to see everything about la voix passive. So I will see you tomorrow. À demain.